some preachers, some pastors that take authority over members.
Uh-huh.
If they don't want the member to go, they say don't go.
Uh-huh.
And look for the members not to go. They say stay, they look for them to stay.
Uh-huh.
Some churches have controlling preachers.
Uh-huh.
That take control over the church. And the members are like little lost people without any authority. But I stop by to tell you, regardless of what man may think, there is one that have all power in the hollow of his hand. One that can do anything. He can speak and man will live. Speak and man will lay down and die. He can speak and the world will stop turning. He can speak and the world will turn again. Well, somebody made a statement. Who is this man? That same question was asked to the disciple of Jesus. Whom do man say that I am? Yeah, you know the story of how they began to tell how people had compared his characteristics with Jeremiah, Elijah, and other prophets, and said, evidently this man is one of them that have come back from the dead. But after a while, he raised the question to a personal note, who do you say I am? Can I get a witness? In other words, you've been with me and watched the miracles. You saw the things that have been done. You saw what has happened around you. The lame is now walking. The mute is now talking. The dead is being raised. Who do you say that I am? You know how it is. It's easy to tell on other folks, but it's hard to tell on yourself. Y'all getting quiet on me. Yeah, that's what's wrong with the world today. We always want to tell on somebody else. Point out other folks' faults. Point out what's bad about somebody else. But have you looked in the mirror at yourself?
Yes.
Have you realized that none of us perfect and all have shunned short of God's glory? All of us are still having issues. All of us are still working on something. All of us are ex something. Y'all been saying that. But because we can't hardly tell on ourselves, but we want to tell on other people. But now Jesus directs the question, who do you say that I am? Now let me say, notice you can't talk about what mama said.
Come on.
Can't go to heaven on mama's religion. Can I help somebody? You can't go to heaven on your friend's religion. You can't get to heaven on somebody else's belief. But the Bible says you must be born again. So if you're going to accept him, I heard Paul saying there's no other name under the heaven that man might be saved except the name of Jesus. So he raised the question, who do you say that I am? After then go to the disciple Peter, said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. In other words, Jesus, I know who you are. Can I get a witness? If the question is asked, do you know Jesus? What will your answer be? Somebody, they say, he's my healer. Because when I was sick, he healed my body. Somebody may say, he's my friend in the midnight hour. Because when I was lonely, I heard him speak to me, rocking me in the cradle of the love. When I was down and out, he picked me up. Somebody may say, he bread when you're hungry. Won't he feed you when you're hungry? I wish I had a witness here. I heard somebody say he's my friend in the midnight hour that stick closer than a brother. He's my friend over troubled water when times get upsetting, when bones round and mistreatment from everything but a child of God. Behold me in the hollow of his hand and keep me when I should lose my mind. Golly said, let me be around me in his arm when it seems like the world has come against me.
My Lord.
Who is the man?
Well,
John said, I saw some men.
Mm-hmm.
Casting out devils is your name. And because they didn't follow us, we told them to stop.
Come on.
Can we just pause for a moment?
Yeah, yeah.
That's why we got so many denominations. Because somebody said, you ain't following me. You were not right. That's why we got so many churches. Because they had somebody say, you're not following me. And you can't be right. You know, a question come up in Sunday school about Baptists and Methodists and Pentecostal and all of this, and I told them there is no such thing as religion or denomination. Whether you believe it or not, there's not but one, and that's the apostolic teaching, which is the teaching of the apostles at the Pentecost when the church was founded. So he said, then, who is the man? Here now, Jesus began to listen at them and said, wait a minute, how are you going to stop him from working in my name? Because if he casted out devils in my name, it means that he's not working against us. He's working for us. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
A lot of times we run good folks off because we feel like they took our authority. But I want you to know they're not working against you. Y'all don't need to talk. It means they're working for you. Sometimes in life, we want to stop folks from praising God because they don't praise him like you and I do. Yes, we look at them, some cry theirs out. Some wave their hands. Some do a holy dance. Some run. Some speak in an unknown tongue. But we don't have to stop them as long as they're doing it in the name of Jesus. Can I get a witness? Can't you see Jesus said, why? Do you want to stop him now when only he's working for us? And he began to tell them, you got to understand that all miracles is worked in my name. Can I get a witness? But he said, anything you ask of the Father in my name shall be given unto you. And I don't know how you feel about it, but he even told us at the Pentecost that we must even be baptized in his name. He told us that in order to get a prayer answered, we must pray in the name of Jesus. Well, you can't pray in spirit name. But there's no power in my name. You can't pray in the name of Sun Young Moon because he had to die just like you and I. You can't pray in the name of Buddha. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You know, some of us want to chat and want to do all kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, the little bald-headed fat man don't answer prayer. And I heard it. Yes, I did say in the accent in Jesus' name. The Father will give it unto you. He said, even if you ask for a drink of water and they give you a drink of water in Jesus' name, he said they will not lose their rewards. And that's why I have an issue with folks that pay money and always talk about I ain't gonna do it because I don't know where it's going. First and foremost, if you have given it in the name of Jesus, you don't have to worry where it's going because God got it in control. Can I get a witness? And then you wonder why you can't pay your bills and your money stay funny. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But he said, if you give it in the name of Jesus, he said, then will I open the windows of heaven and pour you out blessing. You will not have room enough to receive. Can I get a witness? Look here, y'all. He even said, if you want to be healed, y'all don't hear me. He said, you got to ask in Jesus' name. Can I get a witness? Somebody said, well, what? A lot of my prayers have not been asked. But I want to know, did you ask it in the name of Jesus? Because when you ask it in the name of Jesus, God got the answer prayer. Y'all don't hear me? But Jesus said it shall be. Am I right about it? Can't you see here when Paul began to tell us that we need to believe on the name of Jesus? When believing on his name, he said the only way man can be saved except the name of Jesus. He said, well, how can he heal without a preacher? And how can he preach except to be sent by God? Well, I stop by to tell you, if you pray and believe in the name of Jesus, a change, y'all don't want to help me, will happen in your life. So in the name of Jesus, yeah, Lord, the Bible says demons have to tremble in the name of Jesus. Y'all don't hear me? It can't remain the same. Am I right about it? I got to close now. But somebody said, preacher, why is it in the name of Jesus? The Bible said Jesus told us in John chapter 14, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the light. Any man try to come to the Father except by me. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He told us that the only way we can get to the Father, we got to go through him. Somebody said, why, preacher? I'm so glad you asked that question. The law said, kill your dad. The law said, when you sin, stone you to death. But Jesus said, I know that they messed up. The Father forgive them for the wrong they done. I heard him. Yes, he did. Say, I'll die in the place. I got to close y'all, but I don't know what God you say. But the God I serve, y'all ain't saying nothing. He makes a way out of no way. When the devil try to bring me down, he turn around in my favor. I don't know about you, but when I'm sick, all I got to do is call on the name of Jesus. Isn't it all right? Isn't it all right? When you call it, yeah, my Lord, the same God I heard the writer say, I'll step right in when you need it most. I'm trying to close y'all, but I wish I had three people that have tried for themselves. And ain't ashamed to stand up and tell somebody, I tried.
speak peace in the name of Jesus. I shall live and not die in the name of Jesus. There's power, 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 power. You believe it, he says already done. The problem is we don't believe, we don't practice what we preach. We always want God to do something for us, but there's some commands that God said you need to do for him. One thing he said, you got to believe. Am I right about it? Then he told us that he inhabit our praise. See, when you don't feel like it, you ought to lift up holy hands. When you don't feel like it, you ought to tell God thank you for the power. There's power in your praise. There's power in the name of Jesus. The Bible said, when you speak it, it's already done. According to your faith, that worketh within you. I wonder, do you have faith enough to know that in his name, he's working it out. In his name, it's already done. In his name. Your brother, I ain't a slave. I'm a daughter, I'm a soul. It is right. It is right. In his name. Oh, no, your name don't work. But in his name. Have you tried them for yourself? Let me tell you something. A lot of times we wonder why there's a slowness in the Spirit of God. But the Bible teaches us, he gives us a command. Number one, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Can I help somebody? Notice he didn't say sing a song. But if you got breath and believe, it ought to be a praise in your heart. Y'all ain't catching that. Number two, he teaches us you not only got to believe, but you got to act on. Get the Holy Ghost. Read your Bible and read it away. There's nothing Jesus done or the apostles done. They just said do it and it wasn't done. The person that was receiving the blessing, the person that was receiving the miracle, when they say rise up and walk, they stood up. Y'all ain't saying that. When he said take it to that, they took it up. When he said go wash, they went. In other words, you can't sit there and expect the miracle. You got to move. You got to act on it. Because your faith is an action word. Your faith is action. A lot of us say, I want my body healed. But I sit there because I'm hurt. Don't you know that you start to move? By your faith, God got to do something. When I sit in this church and had the stroke, I told the doctor, I didn't care what he said, just get me back to Beth. I said, I'm going to sit in the same spot. I want the devil to know he has no power. And when I got here, I didn't sit there because I was going to walk. I got up. I started walking. In the name of Jesus, God healed my body. What I'm trying to say, if you want a miracle in your life, get up. You got to believe. The Bible said, faith but thy work is done.
Hallelujah. He's a God that loves all. But you got to make a choice to choose you this day who you're going to serve. I believe. I tell everybody, I ain't what I ought to be. But I thank God I'm not what I used to be. But I believe. In the name of Jesus. How about you today? How about you today? I didn't come to prop nobody up. I didn't come to pump nobody up. I come to see how much faith you got in God. You said the Lord God, your love is an action word. Y'all ain't talking. You love God, you ought to do something about your faith. God is speaking to somebody. Need a miracle right now, but you're sitting on your miracle. Somebody need a breakthrough right now, but you're sitting on your breakthrough. Somebody need God to touch that child of God Christ, but you're sitting on your exam. God want to do it, but you got to have some action. How about you today? How about you? Will you let go and let God? How about you? I got the hush. The woman with the issue of blood, she didn't get the miracle that she pressed her way through. She had to put some action. Y'all ain't seen it. The blind man didn't get the miracle until he cried out. When he cried out, God said, get up from there. Spit on the ground, anointed Elijah, go wash. He didn't sit there and say, Lord, I can't see. He started walking in obedience. His miracle took place. How about you today? It's in the name of Jesus. I'm glad. I'm glad. How about you? I'm getting ready to leave you alone. But somebody told me, said, Pastor, I want you to do something. And I'm going to do that. And I'm getting out the way. If you don't mind, Bethel, help me to say this. Oh, I'm singing Mary.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Tell Martha not to moan.
Tell,
oh, y'all don't want
to
hear that.
Tomorrow.
Oh! I'm singing Mary.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Ooh, tell Martha not to moan.
Tell Martha not to moan.
Hey, Rosa, Mary.
Don't
move.
me my time now. I know we got to go. But they tell me there was a man. His name was Lazarus. I heard him say, Jesus. If you had this man, my brother wouldn't have died. Lord have mercy. He said, I didn't ask you to roll the stone away. Y'all mind me talk a little bit. Roll it away. The Bible said had to call him by name. If you haven't called him, everybody would have got it. He said, Lazarus. Gracias.